In your headlines, TCI imports decline. Sandals make effort to revive Caribbean tourism, and 2021-2022 budget passed. Hello, Turks and Caicos. I am Zoe Butler with your July 2nd edition of Newswatch. The real news starts now. The House of Assembly passed the 2021-2022 budget after just 2 days of debate. More in this report.
One of the shortest budget sessions in recent years. Members of the House of Assembly, a large percentage of whom are government members, quickly passed the budget for the new financial year. Here's the Premier as he was wrapping up the budget debate Wednesday evening.
Speaker, as I listened to the opposition leader yesterday, I wondered if he even believed some of what he was saying himself. And I will address each attempt at misinformation, but I promise to be short, as it has been a long day, as I said. The Leader of the Opposition tried valiantly to sell the tenure of the PDM government as one that delivered for the people. Now, I wonder, if you were so good for the people, then why did they fire the entire cabinet except you? Man. Boy, man, they, PNP beat you like you owe us money. And the people send you a massive message at the polls to say that you didn't live up to their expectations. Accept that. Reorganize, rethink, re-strategize. You know, it's going to take you. We realize that 14-1, we haven't taken that for granted. I told you yesterday, right? It is easy to lose that, and we don't intend to lose it.
No, we don't.
We know that your best was not good enough for the people, so we have to do better than you. You say that the people are hard to please. It is not that they are hard to please, Mr. Speaker. They have high standards, and you cannot out. You didn't cut it, and so they cut you.
The Premier says he and his government are open and willing to work with the opposition for the betterment of the entire Turks and Caicos Islands.
The opposition leader says he offered to work with the government to help revitalize the economy. But this was not accepted, he said. Come on up, leader, this is not true. You did make a statement, and you said you were prepared to work with the government, but to date we have not received any ideas beyond that. My team and I are willing to work with the opposition in the interest of the people. That is what you said. On the charge that the people need cash injections, let me say this. First, let me remind the people about how the cash injection was botched by the PDM administration. 25 million, right? Yes. Yes, I added the numbers. $25 million was allocated with a first payout of $1,200 and a second payout of $600. But, Mr. Speaker, the criteria they imposed gave most of the money to work permit holders and locked out most Turks and Caicos Islanders. That was just unjust and unconscionable. Mr. Speaker, of the $25 million stimulus that they budgeted, only $9 million was spent, right? Now, it's very easy to spend money, right? If you weren't organized enough to spend money, what were you organized to do? Less than half of the $25 million was spent. In fact, Mr. Speaker. The truth is known, and I'm happy to admit that about $13 million was left in the kitty when we came to office. We took that $13 million and we added another $2 million to provide cash grants to our people. The money don't belong to the PNP and it doesn't belong to the PDM. It's the people's money. Mr. Speaker, the situation today are different though. We did give everybody who was 18 years old, living in the country, had a citizenship or a BOTC citizen, we gave them $1,000 US. That is a fact, and we did it quickly. The one thing the PNP could do, we know how to spend money.
As he wrapped up the debate, the Premier gave assurances to those who are unemployed that as the country opens up some more, the jobs will come back. For PTV Newswatch, I'm Dalana Isles.
The Enid Cabran Primary School finished the year in spectacular fashion with a teacher's cook-off under the theme Around the World. Alik Harvey with more.
The Turks and Caicos, Trinidad and Tobago, Haiti, and the Bahamas were all represented in Enid Cabran's Battle of the Teachers Cook-Off Chop-Off competition today. The teachers were in for a bit of a surprise when they opened their boxes and discovered the mystery ingredients. The day was intended to be one of socializing and fun for teachers of the Five Keys School to celebrate the completion of a year that was plagued by COVID-19. Devanya Clare and DeAndre Fulford were the staff responsible for organizing the event and told us that the experience was enlightening for teachers and gave us a little summary of how the day came to be.
The countries that are displayed here today were chosen from a bag. I had about 12 Caribbean countries or our neighboring countries, different countries from around the world. In a bag, and the four team leaders had to choose a country from the bag. So the four countries that you're seeing displayed here today were chosen by random by the team leaders. Thanks to our amazing sponsors, who I will not mention here because I don't want to forget anyone. Without you, this would not have been successful.
The teams were chosen at random. The only people that were chosen were the four male teachers. So we made them, the teachers were chosen, the islands were chosen. The countries were chosen, right? So like Trinidad and Tobago, there are TI teachers over there. I don't even think they know really what is going on with the Trinidad, but they have boxes, they have bags, and they don't know what's in the bags. They don't know. So when they take it out, we're gonna give them 10 minutes to look at it and decide what they're gonna cook. Hopefully they did their research and everything, so everything come out magnificent.
We caught up with the judges who told us what they expected from the day's festivities, especially from the winners.
Well, the winning factor is, since they're doing it more of a country theme, I would see how best they stick to the theme of flavors and culinary styles that come from that specific country. So once they stick to that, I think everything is going to be okay, and that group will be on the top.
Yeah, to taste the best of the best, and I understand they're having different cultural cuisines, so that's what I'm here for, to see which cultural cuisine I can lean into on this beautiful Friday. So that's what I'm looking for, good food.
Well, as a judge, as I view the various dishes, I will be looking for dishes with those that are most appealing to the eye, number one, because most persons eat with their eyes first. And flavor, of course, the taste has to be on point.
Relates to food, I love good food. So I think a lot of the teachers that know me know that I like good food. I'm always critiquing food. I'm looking for spices. I'm looking for representation from the islands. I'm looking for you to push your country in my face with your food. That's really what I'm looking for this morning. I saw the Haitian booth set up. I saw a Trinidadian booth set up. I saw a Bahamian booth set up. And of course, a Turks and Caicos Island booth set up. So it's going to be interesting to see what they plug us with this morning.
The winners of the day was Team Haiti. Reporting for PTV Newswatch, I'm Ali Carvey.
A short break now, but more Newswatch when we return.
This is a reminder that all PTV service accounts are due on the first day of each month. Accounts should be brought up to date by the 28th of the month to avoid disruption in service. Payments may be made on our office at Stubbs Diamond Plaza, Providence Jollies, Mighty's Plaza, North Caicos, and Airport Road in South Caicos. Payments may also be made online using Scotiabank, CIBC First Caribbean Bank, and Royal Bank of Canada. Please allow 3 business days for online payments to be processed. We thank you for your cooperation.
Welcome back to Newswatch. The first quarter of the trading bulletin for 2021 revealed a decline in imports for the Turks and Caicos. The United States continues to be our main trading partner with over 80% of imports. Take a look.
The merchandise imports to the Turks and Caicos Islands declined by 22.1% during the first quarter of 2021 when compared to the same period in 2020. Total imports were valued at $93.9 million for the period when compared to $120.6 million last year. Meanwhile, the total number of exports from the Turks and Caicos Islands during this period were valued at $0.7 million when compared to $1.3 million during the first quarter of 2020. The resulting merchandise trade deficit was approximately $93.2 million during the first quarter of 2021. This was roughly 22.1% or $26.1 million below the deficit recorded during the corresponding period of 2020. Officials explained that the decrease in the trade deficit is as a result of a decline in both value of exports, the $0.6 million, and value of imports, $26.7 million. Statistics also reveal that merchandise imports from the Dominican Republic and the Bahamas decreased by 55.79% and 24.94% respectively. Merchandise imports to the Providenciales International Airport increased by 3.88%, whereas imports to the Grand Turk office decreased by 48.31%. The island's main trading partner continues to be the United States, with approximately 86.9% of total imports arriving from the U.S. Officials also explained that given the potential impact of the current pandemic on the different sectors of the Turks and Caicos economy and the lack of a more diversified group of exports, it is likely that the trade imbalance will continue in the foreseeable future. Reporting for PTV Newswatch, I'm Latoya Walken.
The Department of Environmental and Coastal Resources would like to inform the general public of consultation meetings for all motorized and non-motorized water sports vendors. The DECR requests that the public make every effort to attend the meetings to have their concerns noted. The first meeting was held yesterday in Grand Turk. Meetings will be at the DECR office on your island from 6 p.m. to 7:30 p.m. Meetings are scheduled for Providenciales on the 6th and 8th of July, North Caicos on the 13th of July, and South Caicos on the 15th of July. Stay tuned. Your weather forecast and sports authority when we return.
In order to auto-scan your PTV set-top box, you need to follow these basic steps. Turn on your television and set-top box. Press menu on the remote control. Choose installation and press OK. Enter password, press 0000. Choose auto search and press OK. Go down to start search and press OK. Choose yes and press OK. The box will start searching for channels until process bar reach 100%. Click on exit and data will be saved. Click on exit again to continue enjoying the PTV experience. Thank you for supporting the PTV network.
Welcome back to Newswatch. Here is Ali Carvey with your weather forecast and sports authority.
Here is the outcome of the Women's Premier League. Revolution FC lost by 3 to the Academy Eagles. Outcome of the match 4-1 in favor of the Eagles. Teachers FC scored 3 to outwit the Cheshire Hall FC, who managed 2 goals. This ended Cheshire Hall's dynamic win streak. And the Flamingo FC scored 4 goals to claim victory over the SWA Sharks FC, who scored 1. Here are the top goal scorers of the tournament thus far. Hannah Chaplin, Cheshire Hall FC, 10 goals. Raven Marcellus, Teachers FC, 6 goals. Kadeen Delphine, Cheshire Hall FC, 4 goals. Please be advised that the Women's Premier League will not be played on Saturday, July 3rd, 2021. For your Sports Authority, I'm Ali Carvey. Here is your 3-day weather forecast. Grand Turk on Saturday, partly cloudy skies, high 84, low 81, winds east-southeast at 25 to 35 miles per hour. On Sunday, mostly cloudy skies, high 85, low 80, winds east-southeast at 25 to 35 miles per hour. On Monday, partly cloudy skies, high 84, low 80, winds east-southeast at 20 to 30 miles per hour. South Caicos on Saturday, partly cloudy skies, high 85, low 81, winds east-southeast at 25 to 35 miles per hour. On Sunday, partly cloudy skies, high 85, low 80, winds east-southeast at 25 to 35 miles per hour. On Monday, partly cloudy skies, high 84, low 80, winds east-southeast at 20 to 30 miles per hour. North and Middle Caicos on Saturday, partly cloudy skies, high 86, low 81, winds east-southeast at 25 to 35 miles per hour. On Sunday, partly cloudy skies, high 86, low 80, winds east-southeast at 20 to 30 miles per hour. On Monday, partly cloudy skies, high 85, low 80, winds east-southeast at 20 to 30 miles per hour. Parrot and Pine Key on Saturday, partly cloudy skies, high 83, low 78, winds east at 10 to 20 miles per hour. On Sunday, partly cloudy skies, high 84, low 80, winds east-southeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. On Monday, intervals of clouds and sunshine, high 84, low 80, winds east-southeast at 15 to 25 miles per hour. And on Providenciales on Saturday, partly cloudy skies, high 85, low 81, winds east-southeast at 25 to 35 miles per hour. On Sunday, mostly cloudy skies, high 85, low 80, winds east-southeast at 20 to 30 miles per hour. On Monday, partly cloudy skies, high 85, low 80, winds east-southeast at 20 to 30 miles per hour. And for your sunrise and sunset, sunrise 6:11 a.m., sunset 7:37 p.m. And for your high tide 9:41 a.m., 10:04 p.m. And for your low tide, 3:39 a.m., 3:40 p.m. And for your hurricane outlook, for the North Atlantic, Caribbean Sea, and the Gulf of Mexico, the National Hurricane Center is issuing advisories on recently upgraded Hurricane Elsa, located about 20 miles west-southwest of Barbados. Tropical cyclone formation is not expected during the next 5 days. And that's it for your weather forecast and hurricane outlook. We'll be right back for more NewsWatch.
This is a reminder that all PTV service accounts are due on the first day of each month. Accounts should be brought up to date by the 28th of the month to avoid disruption in service. Payments may be made on our office at Stubbs Diamond Plaza, Providenciales, Mides Plaza, North Caicos, and Airport Road in South Caicos. Payments may also be made online using Scotiabank, CIBC First Caribbean Bank, and Royal Bank of Canada. Please allow 3 business days for online payments to be processed. We thank you for your cooperation.
Welcome back to NewsWatch. Over 3 million radio listeners from across the United States tuned in to morning radio in an effort to win a Caribbean vacation. All a part of Sandal's effort to drive recovery of tourism in the Caribbean. Take a look.
Sandal's Resort International has been working nonstop for the past several months to let travelers know that the Caribbean is open for business and reassure them of their safety while enjoying its resorts.
As a part of dedicated Back to Happy and Secluded at Sandals initiatives, the resort's company has already hosted over 2 dozen media personnel, including radio DJs and journalists, since reopening its first resort after last year's closure due to the coronavirus pandemic. For its most recent radio remote, which was live from Beaches, Turks and Caicos, Sandals and its partners engage radio DJs and stations from 7 key U.S. markets, namely Baltimore, Chicago, Phoenix, Omaha, Lexington, Denver, and Nashville. General Manager of Beaches, Turks and Caicos, James McAnally, stated, quote, "We were honored to host media and travel partners at Beaches, Turks and Caicos, the premier all-inclusive family resort in the Caribbean. This has been a great opportunity to remind the world that we are open and ready to welcome everyone back safely." He also added, quote, "Our highly trained staff of superstar team members remain enthusiastic to offer the high level of service for which Beaches, Turks and Caicos is well known. Our beautiful property caters to children and adults, all while adhering to our newly implemented platinum protocol of cleanliness," end quote. Among the visiting radio DJs was Trent Muth Penda. He noted that what he experienced at Beaches, Turks and Caicos is exactly what his listeners in Nashville, Tennessee, where 96.3 Jack FM reaches, are looking for. He stated, quote, "Our listeners love these promotions with Sandals and Beaches. We can't thank the amazing squad at Beaches, Turks and Caicos enough for having us and allowing listeners to live these experiences of life in paradise through us. The best part of the whole experience is the opportunity to change our listeners' lives with a chance to win an adventure like this one," end quote. Reporting for PTV Newswatch, I'm Latoya Walker.
This brings us to the end of another edition of Newswatch. It has been a pleasure having you with us for today's newscast. For more information, visit us at www.ptv8tci.com or come join us here every weekday at 6:30 p.m. I am Zoe Butler. See you next time.